In an m-dimensional space, a tensor of rank n is a mathematical object that has n indices, m to the power n components, and obeys certain transformation rules. What? Exactly. When we read tensor first time, our reaction is similar. But is it really so difficult to understand tensor? While in most definitions, the tensor is said to be the generalized form of the vector. But vector is easy to understand, then why not tensor? In this video, we will try to understand tensor in easy way. To understand tensor, first let's understand the component and basis vectors in a coordinate system. This is a simple three-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system with three axes, x, y, and z. One unit vector is defined for each of the three axes. I cap for x direction, j cap for y direction, and k cap for z direction. These unit vectors are also called coordinate basis vectors. Their length is 1 and their direction is in the direction of the axis. Now let's talk about components of a vector. For this, consider a vector AB which is at an angle from the x-axis in xy plane. There are many ways to find the component of this vector. Like to know the component of vector, project the vector on both axes. For this, we draw a perpendicular line on the axis from the vector, which gives us components in both x and y direction. Another way is to travel from point A to point B. For this, we have to travel 3 times of I cap in x direction and 4 times of j cap in y direction. These 3 and 4 are the components of both direction. I and j are the basis vector for both component. One more thing is that vector not only represent the length but also defines the area. This is called area vector, whose direction is perpendicular to the surface and length is proportional to the area. Now come back to our main topic. To understand tensor, let's take 3 different examples: temperature, displacement, and stress. First of all, let's talk about temperature. Suppose the temperature of water is 300 Kelvin. So, to specify the temperature of this water, we required only one number or magnitude, not any basis vector. Such quantities are called scalar. This means that only one component is required to specify the scalar, not a basis vector. We can say that per component, 0 basis vector is required for scalar. Now let's talk about displacement between any two points. To specify the displacement between A to B, we require the magnitude of displacement, which is 5, as well as the direction, which will be in the direction of AB. This quantity is called vector. So specifying a vector also requires direction along with its component. We can break this vector into its component. When the vector is projected on the axis, vector AB will be equal to 3i cap plus 4j cap. This means to specify vector AB, two component and a basis vector corresponding to each component is required. Basis vector I cap for component 3 and j cap for component 4. In general, when talking about a vector in a 3D space, a basis vector is defined for each 3 components of the vector. This means per component, one basis vector is required to specify a vector. Let us take the example of a beam. We want to find out the stress at point O present in the center of this beam. When an object is deformed by applying external force, the object applies a force internally per unit area against the applied force, due to its elastic nature, which is called stress. If the direction of the force is in the direction of the area vector, then it is called normal stress. But if the direction of the force is perpendicular to the area vector, then it is called shear stress. Both these stresses are of different nature. In order to find out the stress at the point O of beam, we need a cross-section area passing through this point in all three directions. For this, the beam is cut through the point O along the three axes. Now talking about the first cross section, its surface area vector is in the direction of x-axis. Talking about the stress caused by the front part of the beam on the rear, there will be the three components of this stress, sigma xx, sigma xy, and sigma xz, where the first subscript represents the direction of the area vector, such that here the area vector of the cross section is in the direction of the x-axis, and the second subscript tells the direction of the force. If the same method is used for the second cross section, the area vector of the second cross section is in the direction of the y-axis. At point O, the stress will have three components, sigma yx, sigma yy, and sigma yz. Similarly, for third cross section, if the area vector of the cross section is in the z direction, the stress point O will have three components, sigma zx, sigma zy, and sigma zz. In this way, there is total of 9 components of stress at the point O of the beam, which can be arranged in a 3 cross 3 matrix, where all components of the matrix have a magnitude and two basis vectors, one for the area vector of the cross section and other for the force. Here the question may arise that why we did not write sigma xx and sigma yx together by adding, when both are in the same direction. Even though the direction of force in both the components is the same, but still we cannot add them, because the force in both component is being applied to the different area cross section. Sigma xx has the area vector is in the x direction, while sigma yx has the area vector in the y direction. In sigma xx, both the area vector and the force are in the same direction, which will produce normal stress in the material. But the force in sigma yx is perpendicular to the area vector, so shear stress will produce. This is the reason why both components cannot be added in the same direction, because the nature of produced stress is different. The stress at the point O of the beam can be expressed with the help of a matrix, where every component of the matrix tells the force on per unit area. All 9 components of the matrix have a magnitude and two basis vector. One basis vector for the cross section area on which the force is applied, and the other for the direction of the applied force. This means that to specify the nature of the stress at point, it is also necessary to know the direction of the area vector along with the force. It cannot be specified from just one direction. Stress is a quantity that requires two basis vectors per component to fully specify. In this way, we talked about three types of quantities: temperature, which requires per component 0 basis vectors to specify; displacement, which requires per component 1 basis vector; stress, which requires per component 2 basis vectors to specify. Similarly, to specify the piezoelectricity and stiffness of a material, per component 3 and 4 basis vectors are required. Together, these are called tensors. Now, once again, talk about the definition of a tensor. In an m-dimensional space, a tensor of rank n is a mathematical object that has n indices, m to the power n components, and obeys certain transformation rules. Let's break down this definition of tensor. Since most of the time we are dealing with three-dimensional space, so m will be 3. Talk about the rank of tensor. The number of basis vectors required to fully specify a component is called rank of a tensor. Since scalar requires per component 0 basis vector, that's why scalar is a 0 rank tensor. The same vector requires per component 1 basis vector, so the vector is a first rank tensor. While stress in a material requires per component 2 basis vectors, therefore stress is a second rank tensor. Similarly, piezoelectricity and stiffness are tensor of the third and fourth rank, because to specify them, per component 3 and 4 basis vectors are required. This definition states that there will be m to the power n components for n indices. Let's verify it. In three-dimensional space, the scalar has rank of 0, means 1 component, vector's rank is 1, means 3 components, and stress is a second rank tensor, means 9 components. piezoelectricity is a tensor of third rank, then it will have 27 components and 81 components in stiffness. The last part of the definition is that tensor obeys certain transformation rules. This means that even if a quantity is measured in different frames, the value of the quantity should not be affected. Even if its component changes, but the quantity should be the same, such as the distance between A and B. On measuring from two different coordinate systems, the component of AB vector have changed, but the magnitude and direction of AB vector is the same. This is the transformation rule that separates a tensor from a matrix. A matrix is just an array of numbers, but a tensor is a very specified, which obeys certain transformation rules. Hence, the matrix and tensor are different. Tensor is a different kind of mathematical language of representation of a quantity. In this language, Einstein's given notations are used. In the next video of tensor, we will understand these notations and terms like covariant, contravariant tensors.